bless you as you are coming. God bless you. God bless you. Please, let's share this program. Let's share it. Let's like it. As you do so, the Lord will bless you.
Oh, the bottom of your heart. Wherever you are, appreciate this God right now. Appreciate Him. Appreciate Him. He's here in our presence. He's here in our presence. Appreciate Him. Appreciate Him.
Help me, 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 help me
Jesus, mighty name. The Lord has been making way when there is no way. I want you to shout a powerful hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is good. I said the Lord is good. Today is the fourth Wednesday of seven prophetic Wednesdays. And I believe that the Lord is going to bless us tonight in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Quickly before we start praying, as we all know that this is a praying ground and a prophetic night. But before we start praying, I just want to admonish us with one or two words this evening. And I pray that the Lord is going to bless us through this word in the name of Jesus. This night we'll be talking about the secret of greater glory. The secret of greater glory. As we all know, that this glory that we are talking about, that glory that no man has ever used in your family, the Lord is going to deposit it in your life.
Amen.
Ogotaniko olori ninu ebi re Olorun yo gbe wo wa
lori Jesus.
And this secret, it can only be God that can release it to us. It can only be God that can give us this glory, this secret of greater glory. And I pray for us this prophetic night that Lord is going to release it to us more than ever before in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the book of Haggai chapter 2, that is my Bible passage. Haggai chapter 2 verse 9. Haggai chapter 2 verse 9 said, the glory of the latter house shall be greater than the former, said the Lord of hosts, and in this place will I give you peace, said the Lord of hosts. The Bible is telling us this evening, it said, the glory of the latter house shall be what? Shall be greater than the former. What are those glory, the old glory that you have been using before? But God is telling us this evening that the glory of the latter house shall be greater, shall be more super, more than the former one. There is a songwriter that said, for the glory of the latter shall be greater than the former. For the glory of the latter shall be greater than the former. Have faith in God. Kumani jaokule. Have faith in God. Kumani dojutio. Because the glory of the latter shall be greater than the former. And that will be your portion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said that will be your portion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
There is no success without secrets. And there is no possibility without responsibility. There is no success without secrets. And there is no possibility without responsibility. And tonight, God is going to open your eyes to every glory that the enemy might have tied down in one way or the other. The Lord is going to deliver it into your hands this night in the name of Jesus. I said the Lord is going to deliver it into your hands in the name of Jesus. It has been established that greater glory is the will of God for his children. It has been established that what? That God expected us, his children, to be what? To have greater glory. And that glory that God is expecting from us, the Lord is going to give it to us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If you are with me, I want you to type amen.
Amen.
Because God is going to give you every of your heart's desire.
Amen.
I said God is going to give you every of your heart's desire.
Amen.
And the Lord is going to satisfy you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord is going to satisfy you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the scripture where we have read, it said, we see the demonstration of manifestation of greater glory that we are expected to see in our lives, our children, the children of God. We saw that God is willing to manifest his fullness, might, light, goodness, and honor, wealth, and peace in our life. God is expecting us to have wealth. God is expecting us to live in abundance. God is expecting us to live that the glory of God in us will begin to manifest more more than ever before. You know, we have so many people that the glory, they don't even know that they have glory. And that is another one. They don't even know that they have glory. But because as God live and the Spirit live this night, the Lord is going to open your eyes. And you will see yourself that you have glory. And not only you have glory, you will begin to manifest that glory. Amen. That will be your portion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said that will be your portion in the
Amen.
Name of Jesus. We shall look at the key, the access to the greater glory that God is expecting from us. We can see that even in the arrangement of God, Isaac was greater than Abraham in glory. In the arrangement of God, what God has ordained for us, even in the Bible, Isaac was what? Greater than Abraham in glory. Likewise, Jacob was greater than Isaac. I pray for you this night that the Lord will make your children to be greater than you.
Amen.
And before your children will be greater than you, you will manifest glory.
Amen.
I said you will manifest glory.
Amen.
And your children will now begin to manifest, that your children will now be greater. Greater glory.
Amen.
That will be your portion and your family portion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God expects us to enjoy us greater glory than our parents. God expected us to enjoy greater glory than our what? Our parents. The glory that no man has never used, the Lord is going to give it to you.
Amen.
I said the Lord is going to deliver
Amen.
It to you.
Amen.
Before you can begin to glow in glory, which means you have glory already, then you begin to manifest that glory. If you don't have glory, there is no way you can begin to glow in glory. I pray for you tonight that kind of glory that no man has ever used before in your family, the Lord is going to deliver it to you.
Amen.
Oh, glory, God. Oh, God, tell me, glory. Oh, God, tell me, glory. Oh, God, tell me, glory. Oh, be one here. Ogo tani ko lo ti eyan koko ti lo tebi mi o ti ko ni ogo tani ko lo mi o. You know, I said it is a prophetic night. As you are singing that song, God is keeping your word, and is going to bring it to pass in your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, what are the secrets of greater glory life and destiny? Number one, passion for God. You must have passion for God. What are those things that you are doing with God's work that you have not been doing before? You are taking the work of God levitly. You are not doing the work the way you should do it. You must have passion for God before you can begin to use greater glory. I pray for you this night that in any way that you have taken the work of God the way you're not supposed to take it, the Lord is going to bring you out, and beginning from now, you begin to do the work of God more than ever before in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said you begin to do it more than ever before in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When you have passion for God, you will be able to do extreme, more than ever what you even think nor imagine. Your passion for God determine your position with God. Your passion for God determine your what? Your position with God. If you don't have any connection with God, there is no way you can glow in glory. And there is no way you can have all the secrets of God. But when you have passion for God, it will determine your position with God. I pray for you this night that the Lord will position you.
Amen.
I said the Lord will position you.
Amen.
More than never before, the Lord will position you.
Amen.
You will begin to fulfill God's purpose.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Number two, say, follow God's path and plan for your life. When you follow God's plan and plan for your life, things will begin to work out for you. Say a better amen.
Amen.
What are those things you feel that is impossible for God to do in your life? When you begin to, you have patience and you begin to follow God's plan for your life, then things will begin to work for your good. And that will be your portion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Just hold on. Follow the direction of God for your life. And you will never be derailed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because of our time, we can see that one in the book of Exodus chapter 40, verse 33. Exodus chapter 40, verse 33 to 35. The number three said, praising God in the beauty of his holiness. Praising God in the beauty of his holiness. So many of us, we don't know how to praise God. When you praise God, God will do wonders in your life. So when you praise God, you bring God's glory down, then everything in your life, every affliction, every tribulation, every circumstances, I don't know what you are going through, your challenges. When you praise God from the bottom of your heart, God will descend. The Bible says God inhabits what? The praise of his people. When you praise God from the bottom of your heart, God will descend. And God will begin to do what? Manifest his glory upon your life. And that will be your portion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said that will be your portion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the book of Exodus chapter 15, verse 11, it says, who is like unto thee, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like unto thee, glorious in holiness, fearful in praises? Let's sing that song together. Say, who is like unto thee? Yeah. Oh, who is like unto thee? Yes, God. Oh, oh.
Believe that God can do it. No, you must have faith in God. You must
must believe that your tomorrow will be greater than today. You don't just say it with your mouth. You don't just say it because people are saying it. But you must believe. Have confidence in God. That because God is saying, my tomorrow must be greater than today. And that is why the Bible makes us wonder in Haggai. He said the glory of the latter shall be greater than the former. Which means those old glory, those past glory that you are using, those glory that is still there can be greater. This one, this present glory, God is going to make it to be greater. Not only great, but to be greater. If you believe that, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I said, if you believe that, shout a powerful hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Have faith in God. Your faith in God will pull the manifestation of His glory to see greater glory. When you have faith in God, He will pull the manifestation of glory to do what? To see greater glory. And as you do so, the Lord will bless you.
Amen.
To see greater glory, opportunity, greater faith. Believe that God can do all things. If you must see the glory of God in greater dimension, then you must make up your mind. You must make up your mind to do what? To have faith in God. So that the secret of greater glory will be your portion. I said the secret of greater glory will be your portion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Remember this, that there is no success. There is no secret of glory, greater glory, in order to expect greater glory. There is no way, if you want to experience greater glory, you must begin to do all this for God. You must have passion for God. You must have faith in God. You must be ready to obey the commandment of God. Undiluted obedience. You must not mix it with anyone. You must not do it the way you want. You must be ready. And as you do so, you begin to experience the greater glory in your life.
Amen.
In the name
Amen.
Of Jesus.
Amen.
You sing this song with me, sir, as I begin to round up. Oh, go, tell me, go. Oh, go. Open your mouth and begin to talk to God. That kind of glory, oh God, Fire begin to scatter them. In the name of Jesus. Begin to scatter them. Begin to scatter them. Begin to scatter them. For God, me. Strong power in my father's house. Strong power in my mother's house. That has swallowed my glory. Every power, because the power of God is greater than death. Every power in my father's house, in my brother's house. Swallow the glory of my children. Hoya! Begin to commit them. Open your mouth and begin to talk to God. Every power that has swallowed my glory, begin to commit them. Begin to commit them. In the name of Jesus. Every power that has swallowed my glory, oh God of heaven. Begin to commit them. Begin to commit them. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
The Bible says, surely they will gather. But because their gathering is not of God, and for you to receive greater glory, we are not talking about normal glory now. We are talking about the greater glory. You will say, Father. You are not saying that, Father. You are online with me. Say, Father. If you believe God is going to settle you this night, say, Father. Every covenant of evil. That says I will not manifest glory. God destroyed them. Every covenant of evil that says that I will not manifest glory, that says that I will not just manifest. God dismantle them. 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 Amen. You know, there's something that came to my mind now. You know, we have so many people. We have so many people. No one can just look at people. Some people, they will just feel it's normal. It's not normal. God has not created you like that. The Bible says, by fire, by force, we must pray. When you pray, you will receive. If you don't pray, there is no way you will receive. And the enemy will just be happy. Every glory that has been tied down in the prison. You know, there are some glory that has been tied down in the prison. It's not physical prison, no. I'm not talking about physical prison because you imagine. But I'm around now. I'm going now. So how come that I'm in the prison? Spiritual prison. There are some glory that has been tied down. Oh God, in the prison, spiritual prison. You will pray to God and say, Father, every of my glory that has been tied down spiritually, in spiritual prison, Lord, set them free.
Set them free.
Set them free. Open your mouth and begin to talk to God. Have your mighty glory. Heavy of my glory that has been tied down spiritually. God of heaven, by your fire, begin to set us free. Begin to set us free. Begin to set us free. My second ever, Yendari was under it. Begin to set us free. Begin to set us free. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. The greater glory is coming your way.
Amen.
You are not saying amen. Amen. This is the word that I have received this night. The greater glory, Ogodojukolo, is coming your way.
Amen.
I said it's coming your way.
Amen.
If you are still with me, say amen.
Amen.
If you are still with me, say amen.
Amen.
That greater glory, that is the word that I received this night. He's coming your way.
Amen.
I said it's coming your way.
Amen.
That will be your portion.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's begin with this Bible passage as I begin to write up. In the book of Isaiah chapter 60 verse 14. Isaiah chapter 60 verse 14. The Bible says, the son also of them that afflicted thee shall come pleading unto thee. Say amen.
Amen.
They shall come and begin to plead.
Amen.
They shall come pleading unto thee.
Amen.
And all they that despise thee,
amen,
shall bow themselves down.
Amen.
They said they shall bow themselves down.
Amen.
That is the word of God. Said they shall bow themselves down.
Amen.
As thy soul,
amen,
as thy feet.
Amen.
And they shall call thee the city of the Lord.
Amen.
The Zion of the Holy One of Israel.
Amen.
That will be your portion.
Amen.
I said that will be your portion.
Amen.
Say all those people that have afflicted you. All those people that have said negative words about you. All those people that have said, Kosong kokotole chade kuwot inu re. They shall come back.
Amen.
And they shall bow down.
Amen.
Before thee.
Amen.
And they shall call you Zion.
Amen.
They shall call you Zion.
Amen.
That will be a portion.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said that will be a portion.
Amen.
I don't know the kind of word that they have called about you. I don't know the word, the negative word. I don't know what people have said about you. That negative thing, that negative word is coming, the Lord is going to turn it to positive.
Amen.
In your life.
Amen.
And you begin to experience greater glory.
Amen.
More than ever before.
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 Amen.
More than ever before. Makadebo shandaribo sondori makadebo. Yendebo sondori makadebo yendebo. Lekedebo yendebo sondori. Every glory that has been tied down. In the prison, hear the word of the Lord. Begin to receive your power. Begin to lose. I lose you, my fire. I lose you, my fire. In the name of Jesus. Every glory, every power from our father's side, from our mother's side, that said that we will not manifest. We will not use this glory. Whether they like it or not, we begin to manifest it. In the name of Jesus. For the glory of the latter shall be greater than the former. For the glory of the latter shall be greater than the former. Our faith in God, yes, Lord. Never before, that will begin to manifest.
Amen.
The greater glory.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That beginning from now, people will begin to see us.
Amen.
And begin to bless the name of the Lord. Oh God, don't go on call me. Oh, you want to see a year.
Amen.
Oh, you want to see a. Oh God, don't go on call me. Oh God, don't go on me. Don't bow. Let him begin to manifest in our life, in our family,
the secret of greater glory. Wave your hands. Let me see you. You are there. Shout a powerful hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The devil already is in trouble. Because whether the devil like it or not, we'll begin to manifest glory. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That will be our portion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you so much this evening. Thank you for joining us. We really appreciate you. We cannot thank you enough. Thank you for your prayer. Thank you for supporting us in one way or the other. Thank you for your love. We really appreciate you. And I am not taking this for granted. Thank you for joining us. I have been praying this prayer. Journey of life, you will never be alone.
Amen.
I said, in the journey of life, you will never be alone.
Amen.
This is God's program. God is taking us, you know, as the page is the woman of purpose. And whether the devil like it or not, or go at the purpose, at the destiny, they are working together. Whether the devil like it or not, we manifest purpose. We will fulfill our purpose. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you everyone for joining us this evening. I really appreciate you. But there is something I want to appeal. Please and please. I want us to join me. Please, if you have not subscribed to our YouTube page, please, please and please, try and subscribe, please. And I pray that God of heaven will lift you up.
Amen.
You will never be on the same spot. You will continue to go higher.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please, if you have not subscribed to our YouTube page, try and do so. Just go to the YouTube. You will see Women of Purpose International. Just subscribe. They won't deduct your money. It doesn't affect anything on your account. Just subscribe and leave them. Subscribe. That's it. That is what I need from you. That is the only way you can support me. Support me in this ministry that God has asked me to be doing. Support my page. Share our program. We are not begging for money here. Just support me by sharing, liking it, share the podcast. That's all. That is what I need for you. That is the only thing you can use to support me. And as you do so, the Lord will support you in Jesus' name. If you have not followed our page also, Women of Purpose, try and follow the page. Because beginning from maybe next week, we'll start using the page also. Women of Purpose page. So if you have not followed our page, may not be Oluwase Oludani again, but Women of Purpose. Please and please follow our page. And as you do so, the Lord will bless you. Thank you so much, all our mommies, Mommy Moye, Mommy Abimbolu, Bapita, Mommy Awojide, Sakayode, as many people, some people have gone. I want to appreciate every one of you. Thank you so much, Mommy Adeleye. God bless you. God bless you. Try and share this broadcast. The Lord will honor you. The Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. Love you all. God bless you. Thank you so much. And have a wonderful, wonderful night, church.
Thank you so much.
heart desire. Let it perfect. God bless you.